Yesterday, the New York Attorney General's office released a report showing that they believe New York Governor Andrew Cuomo did in fact sexually harass multiple women. He broke federal law and state law by doing this, and of course broke the law by retaliating against at least one of these individuals. Shortly after this was announced, Andrew Cuomo released a video defending himself by essentially trying to tell us that, hey, he's just a gropey guy and he never meant any harm by it. And oh, by the way, he does it to literally everyone he comes in contact with. Take a look at just some of the video that Andrew Cuomo had put out. This is ridiculous. Here it is.
The woman stated that I kissed her on the forehead at our Christmas party and that I said, "Ciao, Bella." Now, I don't remember doing it, but I'm sure that I did. I do kiss people on the forehead. I do kiss people on the cheek. I do kiss people on the hand. I do embrace people. I do hug people, men and women. I do on occasion say, "Ciao, Bella." On occasion, I do slip and say sweetheart or darling or honey. I do banter with people. I do tell jokes, some better than others. I am the same person in public as I am in private. You have seen me do it on TV through all my briefings and for 40 years before that. I try to put people at ease. I try to make them smile. I try to connect with them. And I try to show my appreciation and my friendship. I do it with everyone, black and white, young and old, straight and LGBTQ, powerful people, friends, strangers, people who I meet on the street.
So you can't be a harasser if you harass everyone? Is that really the argument that you want to go with there, Cuomo? Because I don't think that's the stellar defense that you think it is. In fact, it really just makes you come across as even more of a creep. And then he tried to blame it, of course, on, hey, I'm an Italian American. This is what we do. You're really just trying to make an entire ethnicity look bad with that at that point. That is an idiotic argument here. But that's what Cuomo decided to go with. And here's the thing, folks. Those videos were put together in rather short time. I mean, again, this came out not long after the, final report from the New York Attorney General's office came out. So this tells me that they had already put this together. They were preparing for this. You don't just randomly have all of those pictures on hand. Somebody spent a hell of a lot of time putting that together, finding all these photos of Cuomo kissing and awkwardly touching pretty much every individual, as he admits there, he comes in contact with, even people on the street, he says. What about the retaliation, though? Because they also did say you broke the law with that. So, you know, you didn't really address that fact. Point is, Cuomo should have been forced to resign months ago. But Democrats, as usual, wanted to drag their feet, let it all play out, trust the process. And here we are with basically confirmation from Letitia James' office saying, yep, based on what we've done with this investigation that has been going on for months, we can confirm these things. Cuomo needs to step down immediately. Instead of putting out a defense for his behavior, that video should have been his resignation to the country, telling us that he's sorry, he won't do it anymore, and we'll never hear from him again. That's what should have happened in that instance, but it didn't. He is going to ride this thing out because, like so many other politicians that get embroiled in scandals these days, he still legitimately believes he can wait this out. That is what he is thinking, folks. We have to put the pressure on him to resign. We have to let him know that he doesn't have a supporter left in this country. And if he decides to stay, those New York Democrats need to let him know we're going to impeach and remove you and bar you from holding public office here in the future. Your career is over. Kiss it goodbye, like you've apparently kissed everything else in this country.
One of today's video sponsors is Magic Spoon Keto-Friendly Cereal. Magic Spoon is a wonderful cereal that brings back all those wonderful memories you used to have of waking up early, sitting down in front of the TV, watching cartoons with a big bowl of sugary cereal. Well, Magic Spoon lets you relive that without any of the guilt. Magic Spoon has 0 grams of sugar, 3 to 14 grams of protein, and only 4 net grams of carbs in each individual serving. Only 140 calories per serving. It's keto-friendly, gluten-free, grain-free, soy-free, and low-carb. And you can build your own box, or you can get a variety pack with available flavors such as cocoa, fruity, frosted, peanut butter, blueberry, and cinnamon. And Magic Spoon has now brought back 2 fan-favorite flavors, cookies and cream and maple waffle, and they're back permanently. Personally, I actually like to mix the frosted and the cocoa flakes. It gives a wonderful flavor of actually having chocolate cake, again, without any of the guilt. So go to magicspoon.com/ROF to grab your delicious cereal and try it today. And be sure to use our promo code ROF at checkout to save $5 off your order. And Magic Spoon's so confident in their product, it's backed by a 100% happiness guarantee. So if you don't like it for any reason, they'll refund your money, no questions asked. Remember, get your next delicious bowl of guilt-free cereal at magicspoon.com/ROF and use the code ROF to save $5 off.